Coming up, we're joined by security CVP Rob Lefferts to take a look at Microsoft threat protection that harnesses trillions of threat signals from the Microsoft Intelligent Security Graph to secure your workplace. We're going to show you how you can get a unified single console to get visibility to security threats across your identities, endpoints, email, user data, SaaS apps, infrastructure, and more, and how this helps you to build and investigate a connected account of what's going on in your environment, including built-in protections, and how new AI-powered security playbooks dynamically harden your environment through automated workflows. I'm joined today by Rob Lefferts. Excited to have you on the show.
Thanks for having me.
So you lead Microsoft's efforts around threat protection. It's really a topic that never gets stale. It's always relevant because attacks just keep getting more and more sophisticated. Now, I know this is a huge area of investment for us at Microsoft.
That's right. We spend at least $1 billion in security innovation annually. We've developed the Microsoft Intelligent Security Graph, which is foundational to all of our services. We literally employ more than 3,500 security experts internally. This is in addition to our partnerships with law enforcement agencies worldwide through our digital crimes unit.
Right, and one thing on mechanics, we typically cover by the different services all the different security capabilities we have, maybe for Office 365, Windows, Azure. But I know that your team's been working on unifying all of these with Microsoft Threat Protection, but what's the thought behind this?
So to add some perspective here, with the Intelligent Security Graph, we're tracking an average of 6.5 trillion security signals each day across our services. Attacks are coming in from multiple vectors. They could be your identity, your endpoints, your user data across email and documents, your apps, infrastructure, and more. We manage services at scale across all of these vectors, collecting security signals from 400 billion emails scanned per month, 450 billion authentications per month, 1.2 billion devices scanned monthly, 5 billion threats detected on devices, and much more. If you see something in email through signal sharing, we can protect against it in identity. So you really need to focus on both the breadth and depth of the detection and protection that you put in play. There are literally tens of millions of attacks that we prevent each day that are typically undetectable.
Right, so it's a unique role that Microsoft plays in terms of understanding and responding to the threat landscape.
Security ops teams are more and more overwhelmed every day. Typically, people use a variety of tools to keep current, but these can generate a lot of noise with alerts that have little to no correlation. It breaks my heart each time I hear about a breach that was detected, but there wasn't enough time to respond before it got out of control.
Right.
We've seen a lot of cases where teams have literally missed important attack indicators because it's hard to know where to focus. With Microsoft Threat Protection, we are able to correlate related signals across different attack vectors into a single incident. So in addition to allowing you to harness our threat intelligence foundation to keep current, one of the most important things we are doing, as you can see here, is to help you connect the dots across security incidents with a single unified view of what's going on in your environment. To demonstrate how Microsoft Threat Protection provides holistic security for your organization, let's start with a simulated attack. We'll do this using another cool capability in Microsoft Threat Protection called Attack Simulator to simulate email attacks on your end users to help educate them on how to handle modern threats. I'm going to send a simulated phishing email. In fact, Jeremy, you can be the target of the attack.
All right, let's do it. So here, I'm actually in Outlook. I can see there's a mail from my administrator for updating my 401k account, it looks like. So I'm going to go ahead and try to log in with my corporate credentials. And you can see I'm logging as Jonathan Wolcott in this case. It's all branded. It looks like my login page. So this looks fine, but it's not taking my password. So I'll try again and see if I can get this to work. And it's still not working. So it seems like something's wrong. Maybe after a couple attempts, I'll give up and maybe try again tomorrow.
And you've been owned. What happened here is we simulated a phishing attack using Attack Simulator in Office 365. In the real world, an attacker would have done a lot of social engineering research to dupe you into giving away your creds. So let's fast forward a little in time and investigate what might have happened in that real attack.
All right, let's do it.
All right, so I'm here at the Microsoft Threat Protection dashboard. And what I can see is it's bringing together information both in the form of an incident queue, but showing me data from users, devices, email accounts, and all of my organization. I'll click into the incident queue and see what you'd expect, a list of incidents. Each one of these is a full story. So you can see inside the incident, I've got a number of correlated alerts, and I can click through the timeline to see this is how they broke in with a compromised account because you got phished.
Yep.
This is how they used a credential theft tool to grab creds to move laterally in the organization. This is how they started sending outbound email, either to spam or to start to exfiltrate information.
So it didn't stop with the fish, they just kept going.
It was the beginning of a prolonged attack, and they've dug into your organization, and they're going to stick around for months.
Okay.
But we can also drill into details. So let's look at this one alert about Suspicious PowerShell. Mm-hmm. There's a rich set of information here about what happened. You opened a Word document that had a bunch of macros in it that actually started to attack your machine. We can go down further and see another kind of information coming from the identity system. So we see suspicious user behavior in progress. In fact, it looks like a golden ticket has been issued to give this user account more authorization than it should have.
Okay, never a good thing.
All bad.
Right.
But now let's understand what really happened across the organization, because we know it wasn't this one machine, it was multiple devices. Here we see the list of all the devices. And note this for later, it says conditional access applied because mm-hmm. the system has automatically started to contain the breach. We can also see all the users that were impacted. And we see that it hit 4 users in our organization as it moved around. And again, we applied conditional access to start to protect the users.
Right, so these are all the detailed heuristics then effectively, but how do we get details around the detection and the remediation kind of to quarantine and really respond to this attack?
That's one of the most important things Microsoft Threat Protection can do. And as you've seen, as we've gone through, we've put together this broad picture that's driven by automated investigation. And mm-hmm. here we see a roadmap of the playbook making that happen. There's 3 main stages. The first around containment. That's where we automatically apply conditional access to restrict access from impacted users or machines. Mm-hmm. Then there's a process of investigation that pivots across all the entities in your environment. Start with machines, go to all of the files that were impacted, go from there to all of the users, find all of the used machines those users logged into and keep going, building a huge scope. This is where security ops organizations spend 80% of their time, and this is the kind of thing that we can automate to really drive faster.
Because it was all signal from various different providers before, and now it's in one incident.
Pulled it all together.
Okay.
And shown here will actually help you take action and respond. So there are steps that we can take on individual alerts, such as this suspicious PowerShell alert, to make sure we clean up that machine. As you can see from the investigation here, we've looked across all the emails, users, and devices, and we've taken action. We've gone and reset the user accounts that were impacted. We've deleted email, scrubbed it out of inboxes, and we've removed malware from devices so that you know the full scope of breach was cleaned out.
And like you said before, conditional access, we reset their accounts. They might have had to maybe reset their password or even step them up to multi-factor authentication.
That's exactly right. So, powering the whole thing around making remediation easy for users to experience.
Okay, so what if I want to go beyond kind of what's built in, and these are all built in ways to respond through the security playbooks. What if I want to start using maybe maybe something's trending, something's brand new that's infecting various organizations? How would I be able to see that?
Well, one of the things we mentioned earlier were these 3,500 security professionals, and mm-hmm. what they're actually doing is producing threat intelligence. So we keep organizations up to date on what's happening in the threat landscape. You see here threat news. We made up a fake threat attack that we named Bad Kitten just for fun. And what we actually tell you is what's happening for that around the world and your organization. Who are the attackers? How do they work? What are they after? Mm-hmm. And what machines are impacted in your company?
Okay.
You mentioned advanced hunting will actually help you start to look for it in your organization. So let's start an investigation. What we see here is a query using a SQL-like log analytics query language that lets me look, for example, all the browser sessions that were launched from Outlook talking to specific IP addresses.
Right, and this is like what we saw with malware hunting effectively with log analytics on a previous show. Now we have it built into the portal.
It's exactly the same query language. It's built on the same technology, and we've connected it to GitHub. So we actually have repos where researchers and analysts are contributing to a community of how do we find these bad guys. Mm-hmm. We're contributing, others are as well, and we're connecting it into the portal. So when I click here on community, I actually get direct access to that query and can start doing the hunting in my environment.
So can I do things to customize this?
Yeah, I can tweak the query. I can make it look exactly the way I want. It gives me a list of machines and users. I could take action and fix them, or I can actually use this to create a regular detection rule. So I want to stay up to date every day. Maybe nothing's happening now, but keep me informed if something changes and something does start to happen in my environment. Tweak that to specific machine groups, and now I've really created custom TI that works in my environment.
So lots of really great updates that are going to help out security teams everywhere. But what else are we doing to make their lives easier?
In addition, the Microsoft Threat Protection Portal comes preloaded with reports and dashboards to provide insights about the effectiveness of the people, processes, tools in the Security Operations Center.
Right, and these capabilities are really going to help respond to attacks and proactively strengthen your defenses while using Microsoft Threat Protection. Now, what do you recommend people do to get started?
First, check out Microsoft Threat Protection as part of the new Microsoft Identity and Threat Protection offering. We're in the process of rolling it out now, and if you don't see it yet, you can try out Windows Defender ATP, Office 365 ATP, and Azure ATP to get started. Second, if you're looking to really up your security posture across the board, I always recommend using SecureScore to see where you stand now, and scores are weighted based on the effectiveness of the controls you implement. Customers who capitalize on the assessments and recommendations from SecureScore typically reduce their chance of getting breached by 30-fold. And that leads to my third recommendation, because it always tops the list in SecureScore. Turn on multi-factor authentication at minimum for your admin accounts. That's really a critical step. It blocks 99.9% of credential-based attacks. From there, you can get started on your path to passwordless authentication. And with Azure AD, Windows Hello, and users becoming more and more accustomed to it, now is the time.
Thanks, Rob. And of course, we'll keep following the latest security updates on Microsoft Mechanics. So hit subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you soon. Thanks for watching.